So welcome guys again, and today our topic is blood bank anticoagulants. Before we do, if you are new here in this channel, so please make sure subscribe the channel and press bell icon so that you can get notification of future updated videos. Now what is anticoagulant? A chemical substance that prevents the clotting of blood. In daily laboratory, we use EDTA, trisodium citrate, as anticoagulant, but they only provide 4 to 1 days preservation of blood component in normal state. But in the blood bank, we have to store blood for long time, such as for 7 days, 21 days and more, so that we have need some special type of anticoagulants. Now important terms for the blood bank anticoagulant, please remind very carefully. This is very important for the preparation of this anticoagulant. First is citrate. It chelates the calcium, thus prevent the blood clotting. In the coagulation cascade, calcium is one of the very important factor. If we remove this factor by citrate, how can blood clot? Okay. Now citric acid, it prevents the caramelization of glucose during autoclave. Caramelization is nothing but just the oxidation of glucose. It means browniness of glucose due to heat during a process of autoclave. Now why we require this autoclave? So when the solution is prepared, so we have to sterilize the solution. Maybe there is infection during the formation of this anticoagulant process. Another is sodium dihydrogen phosphate. It acts as a buffer, maintain the pH. Okay. Another is saline. This is an isotonic solution for the RBC and other cell. Dextrose is act as a nutrient. It provides energy to the RBC. Adenine, as you know, the ATP full form is adenosine triphosphate. So adenosine is the one of the very important component, and adenine is a substrate for that. Okay, so adenine acts as a substrate for the synthesis of ATP. Another is mannitol. Mannitol is nothing a sugar that reduces the hemolysis of blood and increasing the shelf life of blood. And finally, dextrose, adenine, mannitol are the very important for the increasing storage time of our blood in the blood bank. Type of anticoagulant in the blood bank. Acid is very common, acid, citrate, dextrose. So this is a core component. Okay, please remind very carefully. After that we have to just addition of some extra, but this is the some basic component. First is trisodium citrate, which act as a chelating agent. Okay, citric acid prevent the oxidation of glucose. Dextrose act as a nutrient, because dextrose is our sugar. So distilled water, it give a liquidness to that salt, because this trisodium citrate, citric acid and dextrose present in a salt form. If we take 49 ml of ACD for 350 ml of blood, we can store this blood for 21 days at 4 degrees Celsius. Another we have a CPD, citrate phosphate dextrose. So in the ACD, if we add buffer, okay, I already told you this is a basic component. In the ACD, if we add buffer, it means sodium dihydrogen phosphate, it will maintain the 2-3 dpg level. During the carbohydrate metabolism, lactic acid is formed and it will decrease the pH of blood. In the decreased pH, 2-3 dpg level also decrease, and it will finally affect over RBCs. Now in the solution of CPD, we can store it 21 days at 4 degrees Celsius, same as ACD. But we see more amount of living RBCs in their normal state. So for that we take 49 ml of CPD in 350 ml of blood. Another is CPD-A1, okay, citrate phosphate dextrose adenine. So this is the core component. Okay, in the ACD we have a trisodium citrate, citric acid, dextrose and distilled water. In the CPD we have addition of phosphate. Now in the CPD-A1 we add adenine. Okay, adenine act as a substrate and increase the viability of our RBCs. In this CPD-A1 we can store blood for 35 days at 4 degrees Celsius. For that similarly we take 49 ml of CPD-A1 in 350 ml of blood. So please remind very carefully, in the CPD-A1 we add adenine. Similarly in case of CPD-A2, all the things are similar, just increase amount of adenine. So addition of more amount of adenine in CPD-A, it become a CPD-A2. Okay, this addition of adenine in some extra amount, it will increase the RBC life for 42 days at 4 degrees Celsius. For that, similarly, we take 49 ml of CPD-A2 for 350 ml of blood. Now, another we have a CPD with SAGM. So, CPD is a just simple anticoagulant. SAGM is an additive solution. It contains saline, adenine, glucose, mannitol. In simple word, SAGM is just to provide extra nutrient to the RBC that so that they can live more and more. Similarly, instead of SAGM, we can also use Adisol Optisol, which is also an additive solution because it contains glucose, mannitol, and some extra nutrients such as adenine. Now, all the things are similar, just we have to add SAGM with CPD, okay, and it will give 42 days storage of blood at 4 degrees Celsius. So, in this, we have a two different solutions. First is CPD, another is SAGM. So, how we use it? So, in the blood bank, we have a four type of blood bag. First is single blood bag system, double blood bag system, triple blood bag system, and final one is quad blood bag system. As the name suggests, single blood, that it contain only single blood bag. Okay. In case of double blood bag, it contain extra blood bag. So, our main blood bag is called as a primary blood bag in which we collect the blood. Okay. Addition of extra blood bag into this primary bag called as a satellite. Okay. If the one extra bag is attached, this is called a satellite bag 1. If another bag attached, that is called as a satellite bag 2. If some other bag blood bag is attached, that is called as a satellite bag 3. Now, in the primary bag, or we can say where we collect our blood first, contain a CPD which act as a anticoagulant. After the centrifugation, RBC settle down and we can transport them to a SAGM bag with the help of tube which is connected already to the primary bag. Okay, thus we separate the blood and we can cut it here and store separately. Now 49 ml of this CPD for 350 ml of blood, and in the satellite bag we can use 80 ml of SAGM for the red blood cell. Very important thing, so please remind very carefully. Another is cryopreservation. As the name suggests, cryo mean coldness, okay, or we can say freezing. Sometime in case of very rare blood group, we have to store RBC for longer time, such as for 1 year. So for that, we use this technique, cryopreservation, because in this cryopreservation, internal structure and function of living cell during ultra low temperature and freezing is maintained. Okay. For that, we can use glycerol. Like a simple way, if we collect a blood in blood bag, we can store this blood into 4 degrees Celsius at 4 degrees Celsius. But in case of cryopreservation, we have also add glycerol to them so that it can maintain internal structure of living RBC. In case of RBC, we use glycerol. In case of platelet, we use this DMSO, dimethyl sulfur oxide. So before freezing, we have to just add this cryopreservative, maybe glycerol or DMSO, to avoid damaging of cell structure. Very important thing, because in case of preparation of blood component, this cryopreservation also play very important role. Finally, how much volume of anticoagulant we take for how much blood? So in case of 100 ml of blood, we have to take 14 ml of anticoagulant. For 350 ml of blood, we have to take 49 ml of anticoagulant. And in case of 450 ml of blood, we have to take 63 ml of anticoagulant. Now, if you listen to the video very carefully, so question for you is that, what is different between CPD-A1 and CPD-A2? Thank you.